Mr. Skywalker, again for another episode of Caribbean Current TV. Of course, you've heard the news of what's been happening in Jamaica, in Honduras, even in South Florida with Hurricane Eta and the movements. And by the way, there's another tropical storm that's being formed, so who knows what's going to happen with that. Anyway, let's right now focus on Hurricane Eta and Jamaica. And we have representatives from Food for the Poor down in Jamaica right now that are dealing with the effects of Hurricane Eta. I'm going to let her introduce herself as she does the superhuman work. Please.
Hi, good day. My name is Kivette Silvera. I'm an executive here at Food for the Poor Jamaica. I'm actually, as we speak, out in the field in New Haven, Doheny Park, where the residents have been completely flooded. Yesterday, we were in Bold Bay, St. Andrew, where we have quite a number of citizens who have had flooding and mudslides going through their homes.
Wow.
Yeah, so, I mean, as we speak, I'm actually in the back of a truck. We are going to see how we can assist over 300 residents in this area who have been affected by the rains over the weekend. The houses are completely destroyed. I don't believe that they have the assistance in terms of being able to build back for furniture. For food, we have brought immediate relief in terms of food and hygiene, because with the pandemic, can you imagine not having running water, especially at this time, and having water settle in your houses and not being able to feed the children, you know? So it's really devastating at the moment.
Wow. And those are some numbers for the area you're in right now, which is New Haven, which is still part of St. Andrews, which is close to the capital city. Do you have numbers of what you saw in Bull Bay yesterday?
In Bull Bay, we saw over 100 residents that we had dealt with immediately. And we had over 30 persons who their houses were pretty much completely damaged, meaning they couldn't save anything, that the entire structure went. There are also some families who are being housed in the shelter because they could not stay at their homes. And there are some persons who, unfortunately, they did not want to leave their homes because they were fearful that if they leave, they may lose their belongings. So, I mean, it's when you look and you see the mud halfway to the walls of the home, literally at the windows, can you imagine digging yourselves out of that and trying to get back to normal? And we are expecting rains again this weekend. So we are fearful that you may have even more damage as we go into the weekend.
So in other words, not only do we have the damage from Hurricane Eta, which the level before Hurricane Eta, you know, they're maybe a little bit okay, but we got devastation out of that. But more importantly, there is another one coming, and there's not even okay. We're behind the eight ball because of the damage of Hurricane Eta, and there's more rains coming this weekend. Do I understand?
Well, Jason, if you're looking at my screen, you will see literally that's supposed to be a road. That what we're looking at is supposed to be a road. And this was as a result of Eta. Now, can you imagine? This was after the entire weekend of rain, and they have been like this for a couple of weeks, I get to understand. So it's not just Eta. But can you imagine these residents having to anticipate having more rains this weekend and the water has not yet subsided? You know, it's very concerning. And we are here on the ground, Food for the Poor, trying to assist them as best as possible to see how best we can provide them with some level of comfort during this time. So you are absolutely correct where we are not yet out of the woodworks and the sun is out. However, the rains will be coming again soon, and these persons are still in a state of need.
Wow. And you personally, from what I'm counting, my figures are right, a little over 400 people between yesterday and today. And that's just you.
Correct. So, right. And the thing is, what I must add, Jason, these are the persons who we're able to meet now. Now, there are persons who have been blocked off. So, like Gordontown, the two entrances and exits to that community has been completely blocked. So we have not yet been able to access those areas. to actually see the need that is out there. And we know the need is there because we have persons on the ground who are communicating with us, and we're trying to see how we can get supplies to them. But not many areas we're able to physically access. We would probably need a helicopter right now.
Wow.
To get to these areas.
I hear the Prime Minister have one. Maybe we can borrow it. So listen.
Maybe we can do that.
So what are the types of supplies that you guys know that are needed?
Well, definitely hygiene kits. We need food. We need like water boots. We need like tools that can help to get the water out of the yard and dig out the mud. We need water pumps. And the thing is, I mean, you can't get enough funding in terms of the assist, because what Food for the Poor does, we have a number of suppliers that are ready and willing to assist us. So if persons are not able to donate items, we'll also accept cash, because this will go a long way in helping the persons here in Jamaica. And it's not just Kingston. We have Clarendon that will be going to next. We have St. Elizabeth that has also been affected. We have at least 10 out of the 14 parishes that we have had confirmed flooding and landslide. So that shows you the magnitude of what is happening here in Jamaica.
Wow.
Yes.
All right, so for those of us in the diaspora, because my audience is mainly in diaspora, I guess we could work with Food for the Poor in South Florida to specifically have an impact on what's happening in Jamaica?
Definitely. You can visit our Food for the Poor JA.org website, or you can visit our Florida website, which is foodforthepoor.com, because our Florida team is also partnering with us to assist the persons that are in need in Jamaica. So foodforthepoorja.org or foodforthepoor.com. Either website will assist Jamaicans.
Ms. Silvera, I want to say big respect to your whole Food for the Poor team down on the ground doing what you're doing. We're going to definitely reach out to everybody. Foodforthepoor.com, foodforthepoorja.org. We will keep that information going out there and let people know. Thank you for all that work. Today is Veterans Day in the United States. So I'm looking at you as a soldier who's really doing the work. Big respect, Mr. Lair. Big respect.
Thank you, Jason. Thanks to the team as well. Thank you.
This is Caribbean Current TV, and we are going to be really keep on paying attention to what happened with Hurricane Eta and other storms that are coming through. Food for the Poor doing the work, and we can see we can do what we can to help them out. We'll have the information, and we'll tell you more about it. Big respect. Coming straight to you from Jamaica Live, from the damage of Hurricane Eta.